Hello, in this lecture we will show you how to remove a lambda from an NFA. These types of applications are basically needed in lexical analysis where the NFA is present to us, but we need to remove the lambda from that NFA, and after that we have to convert it to machine to see that what are the return type that we are going to get when the machine reaches to the final state. Now here I am showing you one examples where two lambdas are present. One lambda is in this place and the lambda from Q1 to Q2. Now the basic rule is that we have to decide that which lambda we need to remove first. If we think that we have to remove the lambda between Q0 to Q1, that case here Q0 is the originating state, that is V1, and Q2 is the terminating state, that is V2. Now we have to first identify that which one is the originating state and which one is the terminating state. Next, whatever be the edges that are generated from the terminating state, that is Q1, all those edges will be copied to the originating state, and after that we can remove the lambda. Means that my terminating state is Q1, and from Q1 what are the edges have been originated? One is being originated and it is terminated to Q1. Another is lambda is being originated and it is terminating to Q2. So to remove the lambda from here, what we have to do, that we have to copy these two things, this one and this one, at Q0. Now after copying this one, let us see what happens. Lambda is being removed. Now from Q1, as lambda has been originated to Q2, this one will be copied here. So I can say that this one is the copy of this one. Next, from Q0 to Q1, one will be copied, means that this one is the copy of this one. So my first step is done. That means whatever be the edges that are originated from the terminating state, that will be copied to the originating state without keeping any other things same. Next thing is that if the originating state has the initial state, if the originating state contains the initial state, then terminating state will also contain one initial state. So as Q0 is the initial state, so Q1 will also be the initial state. Next, if the terminating state is the final state, that case we have to make the originating state also the final state, but the terminating state is not a final state, so we will not do anything. Now the irony part is that we are going to remove the lambda from Q0 to Q1, we have generated another lambda from Q0 to Q2. No issue, we have to remove that lambda also again, that means Q0 to Q2 as well as Q1 to Q2. Okay, now let us remove the lambda in between Q0 to Q2. We will copy the other states, whatever as it is. Now to remove lambda between Q0 to Q2, what I have to do, that I have to copy whatever the states that are generated from Q2, I have to copy it to Q0. So from Q2, 2 is being generated and it is originated and it is terminating to Q2. So the copy will be from Q0, 2 will be originated and it will be terminated to Q2. Means that this one is the copy of this one. Okay. Now, as Q0 is the initial state, we have to make Q2 also initial state. As Q0 is the final state, we have to make Q0 also as the final state. So, in this way, we have removed the lambda between Q0 to Q2. Next lambda is between Q1 to Q2. Now I am copying all the states and their edges. And this lambda also. Now this time I have to remove this lambda. Now to remove this lambda, same thing we will do, that what are the edges that are originated from Q2 that will be copied to Q1. Means that I have to copy Q1 to Q2, that is 2, and as Q1 is the initial state, so I have to make Q2 also initial state, that already has been done, and as Q2 is the final state, I have to make Q1 also as the final state. So in this way I have removed all the lambda, and this is the ultimate the final NFA without lambda. Now what is the physical significance of this one? Look at this one, that at Q0 if you give 0 it is going to Q1, and if you give 2, if you give 2 it is going to Q2, and at Q2 if I give 2 it is going to Q1, and if I give 2 it is going to Q2, and at Q2 it is taking Q2 only. Another thing is that Q0, Q1 and Q2 all are initial state and all are final state also. The physical significance is that here Q0, Q1, Q2 all are equivalent state. That means the properties of Q0, Q1, Q2 all are same. So, if you reduce this machine using either method of closed partitioning or mark and reduce procedure or merger table or merger graph, ultimately you are going to get this one, that Q0, Q1 and Q2 all are equivalent state, and if you give 0 over here, if you give 1 over here, or if you give 2 over here, that will be rotated within the same state. Now I am giving you another example so that this concept will be clearer to you. I am giving you another example. So in this case we have to remove the lambda from Q0 to Q3. Now to remove the lambda from Q0 to Q3, what I have to do, that whatever be the edges that are originated from Q3, two edges has been originated, one is 0 to Q2, another is 1 to Q4, I have to copy both of them to Q0 only, and we will remove the lambda from here. So we will remove the lambda from here. and rest of the state will remain same as it is. Okay, now from Q3, 1 is being generated to Q4, that will be the copy 1. Means that this one is the copy of this one. Now I have to copy this one. Means from Q0 to Q2, 0 will be generated. So I can say that this one is the copy of this one. Okay. Now, as Q0 is the initial state, we have to make Q3 also as initial state. This one becomes little bit clumsy, but the rule is same. Now, as if Q3 is the final state, that case I have to make Q0 is the final state, but Q3 is not a final state. So, as there is no other lambda is present over here, so this is the ultimate result without lambda.